still small voice. It was in 1 Kings, and it said, God has all kind of ways to get your attention. You got tornadoes, thunderstorms, and hurricanes, and earthquakes, and things seem to shake up your life to get you to understand that he's always there. Sometimes we want to go to other things. But he said that he doesn't always need fanfare to get your attention. Sometimes he comes in a small, still voice. So you have to listen very carefully. Because if not, you may miss his instruction to you. But the other part is that once he give you those instructions, you got to be obedient to follow those instructions. But that was last Sunday. And now this is this Sunday. This Sunday, if you would, please turn to 1 Thessalonians, the first chapter. That's in the New Testament. And I'll be reading from the Harper College Study Bible. So imagine it'd be a little different from yours. Different translation. But it's all good. That'll be 1 Thessalonians. First chapter. Mm-hmm. And you get there, but you acknowledge it by saying amen.
Amen.
I want to raise up one verse this morning. That's verse 2. It says, we always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers constantly. We always give thanks to God for all of you, and mention you in our prayers constantly. We just celebrated Thanksgiving last week, and some of us had some good dinners. I ate good because of Canada, churchmen. Ain't had some chitlins. If you get down to the north, they say chitlins. Down south, they say chitlins. We had some good food. Got to see some family members. It was a holiday called Thanksgiving. They said back when America first started, the Indians and the Pilgrims got together. And maybe that's why we celebrate Thanksgiving. And all that's good. But today we want to take it to another level because the Apostle Paul clearly gives us an example of a thankful attitude. Let me begin like this. It says in every epistle, that's a letter, that's all that word means, epistle. In every letter that Paul's first words are those of thanksgiving and praise to God. Paul made this suggestion in 1 Thessalonians 5:18. He said, in everything give thanks. Paul's thanksgiving was not dependent on his personal circumstances. It's easy to give thanks when everything is going okay.
Amen.
You know, Billy Warren, you get a raise on the job, and you got $300-$400 in your pocket. Your rent is paid, and your gas and light is paid. Now, you pay all your bills, you still got $100 left. It's easy to give thanks when everything is going good. But it said that he continued to thank God despite many hardships. Paul had a pain resume. You know what a resume is. I looked at my resume the other day and it has a resume. It shows your experiences in life. You have your education on your resume. Where you went to school, you have your work history on your resume, where you have worked in the past. And then it has experience in organizations that you have that belongs to on your resume. You have special awards on your resume. You take your resume when you go look for a job. But Paul had a Payne resume. Let me just read Paul Payne resume. And it was in 2 Corinthians. You can write it down and read it later for yourself. It was in 2 Corinthians 11. 22-33. After all this, Paul gave thanks. Here's Paul Payne's resume. Paul said, to which Paul said, I am talking like a madman. I am a better one, with far greater labors for more. Imprisonment with countless floggings and often near death. 5 times I have received from the Jews the 40 lashes minus one. 3 times I was beaten with rods. Once I received a stoning. 3 times I was shipwrecked. For a night and a day I was adrift at sea. On frequent journeys in danger from rivers, danger from bandits, danger from my own people, danger from Gentiles, danger in the city, danger in the wilderness, danger at sea, danger from far brothers and sisters in toil and hardship through many a sleepless night, hungry and thirsty, often without food, cold and naked. And besides other things, I am under daily pressure because of my anxiety for all the churches. In other words, he was a pastor of many churches. And after all that, he had to come home and deal with church folk. He had to, after being shipwrecked, he had to come and deal with the choir. He had to come and deal with the trustees. He had to come to deal with the committees after all that. But yet and still, he gave thanks. Oh, I felt kind of ashamed when I started complaining about my own stuff. After reading all that, I can't never complain. I got to always give thanks. I got up this morning, the biggest thing I had to worry about was which shirt to wear. And after all